Thor was surprised as he heard what sounded like a distant screech. At first he thought it was just his mind playing tricks on him, but then he felt a chill as he heard it again. He raised his hand to his eyes and looked up, studying the skies. He could have sworn it sounded like the cry of a dragon, and yet he knew that was not possible. The last of the dragons, he knew, had died with Ralibar and Mycoples. He had witnessed it himself, that fateful moment of their deaths still hanging over him like a dagger in his heart. There wasn't a day that went by when he did not think of his good friend Mycoples, when he did not wish he was back at his side. Was it just wishful thinking, his hearing that cry? The echo of some forgotten dream? The cry suddenly came again, ripping through the skies, piercing the very fabric of the air, and Thor's heart lifted as he felt numb with excitement and wonder. Could it be? As Thor raised his hand to his eyes and looked up into the two suns, high up above the cliffs, he thought he detected the faint outline of a small dragon circling in the air. He froze, wondering if his eyes were playing tricks on him. "Is that not a dragon?" Rhys suddenly asked aloud. "It is not possible," O'Connor said. "There are no dragons left alive." But Thor was not so sure as he watched the outline of the shape disappearing into the clouds. Thor looked back down and studied his surroundings,